In this video, I will be talking about LCD. This time around, we'll be paying a bit more attention to the liquid crystal. Like we already know, LCD is liquid crystal display and would be used on most entry-level devices and basically in majority of the devices in the market today. This is due to the fact that LCDs are very cost-effective. LCDs are way cheaper to manufacture compared to their OLED-based counterparts. LCDs are made of these basic components. So let's take a closer look, zooming down to the pixels. We already talked about how each pixel contains three colors, primarily the red, blue, and green, which can combine to create every other color on the color wheel. But observe this. When you combine the three primary colors, you get basically white, which means every white color contains the three primary colors. If you can just find a way to separate them or filter them out of the white, this is the major reason why most LCD displays would have a white backlight, except for some quantum dot models used by Samsung, which uses blue. But then, that's because they involve quantum dots, which we would be talking about later on. The backlight is usually a bunch of white LED bulbs, and these bulbs are used primarily as the light source for the screen, after which you get the diffuser. The basic work of the diffuser is to soften the lights, so you can't basically see the individuality of the bulbs from the screen. The diffuser basically spreads the light out evenly to every part of the screen, so you just have one plain flat white surface. So now we have an evenly distributed white light source. Next, you get the liquid crystal, which is in between the light and the filter. What majorly forms the pixels are color filters. And what the color filter does is to receive the white light and pick a particular color out of it. So the red subpixel you see is basically a red filter for white light, which means if you pass white lights through that filter, it basically picks out the red. And then you have the blue filter. And then you have the green light filter, which basically forms the pixels. The most important component is the liquid crystal. The liquid crystal is what regulates the intensity of light that passes through to each color filter, which forms the subpixel. The liquid crystal does this by changing the polarity of the liquid to make it more transparent or more opaque. The more transparent the liquid crystals become behind that particular subpixel, the more the intensity of light that passes through it, the more opaque and dark the liquid crystal becomes, the less light would flow through that particular subpixel. So the liquid crystal in the liquid crystal layer basically does the work of light intensity regulation for each subpixel simply by adjusting polarity. Which means, in order for the screen to show black, the liquid crystals would have to be completely opaque. This has brought a major challenge to LCD displays because the liquid crystals do not completely go opaque in order to block light up to 100%. So some tiny little amount of light will still pass through the liquid crystals to get to the subpixels, giving off a gray-like feel that is not entirely black. Something we like to call false black, as opposed to the true blacks you get from OLED. You see, OLED can completely turn off the pixel like a light bulb, so it's completely black. But LCD would simply make the liquid crystal to become opaque and non-transparent, so a little amount of light would still pass through, which brings us to the innovation of local dimming. TVs with local dimming have the ability to turn off specific backlights in areas of the screen where black is being shown, so there is no light passing through the liquid crystal, and that grayish feel can actually be black, which means the TV has to constantly track what is being displayed on the screen to know where requires more light and where requires less light, making the backlight panel behave like a screen itself, and forming patterns of light that is similar to the color being displayed on the TV, which you see on most mini TV commercials and adverts and product shows like this one over here. Nevertheless, filtering specific colors from white light might give a really good display, but it won't give such a perfect colorful display like what you'd find in OLED, because OLED is basically giving off the colors directly from the subpixels, while LCDs is basically filtering out a particular color from white light. So if you position an LCD display beside an OLED display, you'd see a clear difference in color fidelity and contrast. The OLED would be far more colorful, while the LCD would appear a bit kind of like it's whitish or like it's washed out because it's basically filtering light. Also, an LCD display would give off this inky feel when you place a little bit of pressure on the screen. The ink-like thing you see on the screen is the liquid crystals. If you give it just enough pressure, it could spill, and that's going to destroy that area of the screen. Now multiply this in millions of little cells on the screen, and you have your display. The major advantage of using LCD devices is the ease at which you can replace your screen, because LCDs are easier to manufacture and cheaper in price compared to their OLED counterparts.